Good morning, student. In last class, we have studied about the plant tissue. Just will recall what we have studied in last class. Yes, tell me what are the different types of plant tissues? Yeah, we have studied different types of plant tissues. In that, we come to know that in plants, the tissues are mainly categorized into two types. That are, they are meristematic and permanent tissue. And we have studied the difference between these two, right? Yes. After that, we have studied different types of meristematic tissue and where it is found in plants. And we studied about the permanent tissue and its types. Yes. So, student, what you are thinking? Whether only plants are having the tissues? What about the animals? Whether animals are having tissue or not? Yeah, what is your answer? Yes, we know that we have tissues. Animals are having tissue. Those tissues are present in animals are called as animal tissue. Those tissues present in plants are called as plant tissue, and the tissues present in animals are called as animal tissue. So that in today's class we are going to study about the animal tissues. Animal tissues. Student, do you know any animal tissue? Any animal tissue? Already we have said about the some tissues when we are starting our lesson. That is, what are the different types of animal tissue you know? Yes, good. That is a muscular tissue. And any other tissues? Yeah, you know that we have nervous system, so that nervous tissues. And any other tissues? Yeah, you know that bones we have, upon that we have blood we have, so that is called as connective tissue. And one more tissue is the epithelial tissue. So animal tissues are categorized into four types. They are muscular tissue, second one nervous tissue, third one epithelial tissue, and connective tissue. Fourth one is a connective tissue. I will repeat once again: muscular tissue, nervous tissue, epithelial tissue, and connective tissue. Okay, these are the four types of animal tissue. So all these tissues are present in our body and in other animals also. Okay, next, see, do you know any of these tissues? Do you have any ideas of these tissues? Yes. So I will say you a small incident. One day morning, Raju, he decided to go gym. Do you know what is gym? What is gym? Why the people are going for the gym? What is there in gym? Yeah, you all know. See, one day morning, Raju decided to go gym. So he went and he started whatever the works they are doing over there. Okay, all things, all the activity he started. Lifting weight, upon that push-ups, all those things, you know. Like a cycling, all those things is there, no? Yeah, all he done. Next day, what had happened, you know? He got pains. In entire body, he is body ache. Pain he is getting. Upon that, in some places, he got the sore, as swelling also. Why it is so? Do you have same experience? Whether you have the same experience? Yeah, in lockdown time, what your mother or parents are saying? To clean your house and all. First time you are doing the cleaning of house, first you are doing that work, what happened? Same thing you are getting. Same feeling you are getting, that next day your body start to pain. Okay, muscles pain. Yeah. Next, what you are saying, why it is so, the pains are why? That is because of your skin. Yeah, what you are saying, that is because of your skin? No, it is not because of your skin. That is because of your bone? No, it is not because of bone. That is because of your nerves? No, it is not because of the nerves. But why we are getting pain? Why Raju got the pain? Yeah, that is because of his muscles. Do you know, student, what is muscles? Yeah, why we need these muscle tissues? Why we need this muscle tissue? Yes, muscle tissues are very, very important tissue for the movement of any organism. Upon that, the movement of our body parts. So, I can lift my hand. We can walk nicely because of our muscle tissues. So, we'll study about the muscle tissues first. Yes, I will write here. See, here it is there, muscular tissue. See, muscle tissues are called as a muscular tissues. See, muscular tissues are consist of elongated cells. What is that elongated? Yeah, elongated, lengthier cells it has. Okay, that is called as muscle fibers. What? It is called as muscle fibers. Fibers. See, muscle tissues are called as, they have the elongated cells. Those cells are called as muscle fibers. Come to know, muscle tissues are having muscle fibers. Yes, we already come to know that muscle tissues are responsible for the movement of our body or else our body part. Okay, yes. Next, they have a special kind of proteins in that. Okay, those cells, those cells means what? The muscle cells or muscle tissues are having the special protein in it. It is called as contractile proteins. Okay, I will write here, that is contractile proteins it has. Yeah, come to know, it has a contractile proteins. Yeah, these contractile proteins are responsible for the movement. Just think of student, in our body, we got any disturbance for the contractile protein, what will happen? Yeah, our muscle won't move, so that we will feel very difficult to move or lift our hand or to walk. Okay, come to know, this is about the muscular tissue. Next, muscle tissues are further classified into how many types? Here we have written, see here, there are three types of muscle tissues or muscular tissue. See, we'll see one by one here. See, first one is a striated muscles. That is striated muscles. Second one, unstriated muscle. Third one is cardiac muscle. Okay, we'll study one by one. Okay, before that, next tell me student, striated means what? Just you have to tell the meaning of that one, striated. What is that striated? It is having the striations. What is the striations? Striations means it has a band, light and dark band. So I will draw you here. See student, I will draw and show you. See, if it is a muscle tissue, it has a bands in it. Okay, some bands are dark, some are very light, some are very dark and some are very light. Alternatively, it has a dark and light band in it. Okay, that is, actually we are taking a small piece of muscle, it is muscle tissue it is. Okay, if you are going to see or else observing under the microscope, we can see a beautiful structure of muscle cell. Okay, see, this is a structure of striated muscle. Can you see now? See, here we can see both the band, dark and light bands are there in the striated muscle. Striated means nothing but it is having the striations. Striations means what? It has light and dark band. Okay, you can see here, no? Yes. Now, other than that is the first point we got from the striated muscle. Other than that, can you guess any point from here? Any other characteristic of these striated muscles? Any other points? Yes, we can see here the nucleus. I have written here, it is a nucleus. See, how many nucleus are there? Actually, I have taken a small piece. See, still it is continuation is there. Only a small piece I have taken, I have drawn here. See here, how many nucleus you can see in this? number of nucleus. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 nucleus in this small piece. If you are going to see entire muscle tissue, we can see a number of nucleus. So, it is having what? Multinucleated. So, it is having multinucleated what? Muscle tissue it is. Come to know, 2 points also we have got, what and all? First one, it is having striations in it. Second one, it is having multinucleus, that is number of nucleus is more than 2. Come to know? Yes. Next, we'll see other points, what it has. Let us see more about striated muscles. Okay. Already we come to know that it is having the dark and light band. We'll see other points what it has. Okay. See, first point, it is a cylindrical in shape. We come to know that it is having the cylindrical shape. Yeah. Next, one more point, it is unbranched. Whether we can see any branches in this? No. So that we can say simply that is unbranched tissue it is. Next point, dark and light band. Already we have discussed about that. Next, they are mostly attached to the bones. Okay, whenever these tissues we are observing, always it is present in or else attached to the bones. So, it is called as skeletal muscle. Skeleton means nothing but it is a bone. So, always it is attached to the bone. So, it is one more new name for that one, that is skeletal muscle. Come to know? Next, one more point, muscle present in our limbs move when we want. So, it is called as what? Voluntary muscle. See, voluntary muscle means nothing but the muscle present in our, see, limbs or else in our hand, fingers, all those things. See, whenever we want to move our hand or limbs or fingers, see, we can easily, we can move or else we can lift our fingers or hand. See, that is called as voluntary muscle. Voluntary means nothing but it can, it is what associated with or else we can move that one freely. Okay, so that three names for these muscle. What are those? First one, it is striated muscle because it has a striations. Second one, it is also called as skeletal muscle because it is attached to the bones. Third one, it is also called as voluntary muscle because it is moving one. So, moving muscle it is. So, attached to the bone, along with that we can move or else we can lift. So, that voluntary muscle. These are the main characteristic of striated muscle. Next, we will move to the unstriated muscles. Unstriated. What it means? The name itself indicates that unstriated. So, it does not have any striations. What is striations? Nothing but it has a dark and a light band. But these muscles are lack of that one. Does not have any striations. So, what will be the shape of that one? It is not at all this elongated shape. It is having the spindle shape. So, I will draw and show you, student. Very simple it is. It is having the spindle shaped muscle cells. This is a one cell. So, number of cells will join together and we are calling it as a tissue. So, that it has a spindle shaped muscle cells, or else the group of cells. See, like this it is. At the center, we can see a nucleus. So, here how many nucleus are there? Only one nucleus. While studying the striated muscle, we have seen that it has a number of nucleus. So, we are calling that as a multinucleated. Then, what we can call this? See, it is having the single nucleus. So, it is called as uninucleated. Come to know, uni means it is single. So, nucleated, it is having the single nucleus. Yes, come to know, no? Yes, next we will see where we can find this one, unstriated muscles. Let's look at here, student. So no striation is the first point. Already we discussed about that. Next one, it is present in the alimentary canal. Upon that, it is there in the uterus, iris of the eye and bronchi of the lungs. What is the alimentary canal? You know that alimentary canal, it is there in our digestive tract. So there we can see this one. Next one is in a uterus, that is a female reproductive part. Okay, uterus is a female reproductive part. There also we can see this one. Upon that, iris of the eye. You all know that where is, what is iris? See, in our eye there will be a, see, dark. We can see the color change, that is the iris. There also we can see these muscles, that is helping for the contraction and relaxation of our eye. In uterus, contraction and relaxation of the what, baby, what is there in the uterus. Okay, next one, in bronchi of the lungs. In lungs also, in the bronchi, we have studied what is bronchi, entire respiratory tract, we know, we have studied in our previous classes. In that, in bronchi also, we can see this one. Yes, next, the shape is what? That is a spindle shaped one. Next, tell me that whether it is a voluntary or involuntary. Actually, it is involuntary. What is meaning of that? Involuntary means what? Yeah, involuntary means it is not a moving one. While we are studying the striated muscle, we studied that it is moving one. So that we can lift our hands, we can walk, fingers also we can. Yeah. But here, these spindle-shaped muscle cells are involuntary in nature and uninucleated. Next, look at this picture, student. How this, there will be a point end is there. For each cell, there will be a point end. So, point end also there for the cell. So, cells are long with pointed end. Actually, it is a very lengthier one and it has a pointed end. This is about the unstriated muscles. Come to know the main point, no striations. Present in alimentary canal, uterus, iris, upon that bronchi of the lungs, and it is having no branch, uninucleated, spindle shape, point end is there. Okay, all those things are the characteristic of these muscle fibers. Okay, next we'll move to the cardiac muscle. Before that, in unstriated muscle, I forgot to tell you one thing, student, that it is also called as a smooth muscle. Already we have discussed the characteristic. We come to know that it does not have any branch, nothing. So it is very smooth. Okay, it is also called as smooth muscle. Next, we'll move to the cardiac muscle. How it will be the cardiac muscle? Where it is present in cardiac muscles are present in which place? Yeah, that is in heart we can see. In heart we can see the cardiac muscle. So it is also called as cardiac muscles. Come to know, cardiac muscle is also called as heart muscles because it is present in heart. Next we'll see the characteristic of that one. It is cylindrical in shape. Already we have studied striated muscle, same as that, it is also having the cylindrical structure. Yes. Next, it is branched and uninucleated. But the difference is here, it is branched. Striated muscle, there is no branch, but it is branched and uninucleated means what? It is having only one nucleus in this. Involuntary in nature, whether we can move our heart, we can move? No, our body system, what it is going to pump the heart, only that much, it is not moving from one place to another. So, it is having involuntary muscles. Come to know, the involuntary action of cardiac muscle is because it is not moving. Yes? Yeah. Muscles of the heart show a rhythmic contraction and relaxation throughout life. Yes, we all know that heart muscles always, it is going to pump. Daily it is pumping. Okay? So, throughout the life it is going to relax and contraction is occurring in the heart muscle. That is a function of heart muscle. One more function. Muscle is to to control the contraction and relaxation of the heart. That is already we have discussed, that is a function of heart muscle. So can you draw the structure of heart muscle, student? After discussing the characteristic, you are able to draw the structure of heart muscles, right? So can you draw? Yeah, I will show you, student, how it will be. See, it is elongated. We come to know that it is elongated, but it has what, branches. So you have to rub some more here, and you have to a small branch you have to draw. Yeah, there will be a connection between the what, two muscle tissues. Yeah, there will be a branches here. See, you can draw like this. It is a branches. Yeah, next, what is one more point? It is elongated and it is half cylindrical and it is having the uninucleated. How it will be then uninucleate? If you are taking one tissue, this much, one cell, we can see one nucleus here. One, see, if it is one cell, we can see one nucleus. In one cell, we can see one nucleus. Upon that, it is also having the striations. So we can draw like this, striations, dark and light band, dark and light band. Continuously you have to draw like this. So that is the main point. It is having the elongated structure. Upon that, it is having the branched structure. It is having the uninucleated. So it is present in where? Yeah, heart. So it is also called as heart tissue. So that we have completed about muscular tissue. Next, we will move to the nervous tissue. Yes. Next, we will move to the another tissue, animal tissue, that is a nervous tissue. Do you know anything about the nervous tissue? Any idea of nervous tissue? Yeah. Nervous tissue is also called as a neuron. Okay. Actually, the nervous cell, a single unit of nervous tissue is called as neuron. That is a single cell of nervous cell. Okay, nervous tissue. Come to know, that is called as a neuron. Yes. Next, we will see the structure of neurons and what are the different characteristics of these neurons. Yeah. Actually, these neurons are, it is very important muscle, sorry, important tissue in our body. Actually, these tissues are responsible for the stimuli. Yes, can you give any example when our body is response to a stimuli? Yeah, I will say a small thing, a small incident. When you are touching the heart vessel or utensil, what you are doing? If it is a very hot vessels or utensil, any pan it is, what you are doing? Just you are taking your hand back. Same thing, when you are seeing the snake in flow, what you are doing? Just you are coming back, you are taking your leg back. Why it is so? Why you are doing that one? That is because of our nerve cells are responding to the stimuli. Yes, come to know, they are responding to the stimuli. How fast they are giving the impulses, you know, student? They are very quick, they are giving the impulses very soon. Because of that, you are that much fast. If you are touching the utensil, hot utensil, immediately you are taking it. You are not taking half an hour, one day like that. Immediately it is giving the response. See how fast it is. So it means that, it indicates that the neurons are passing the impulses are very quiet, very quickly they are doing. Their work is very quick, rapidly they are doing. So we are taking back our hand or our leg. Okay. So where it is present? The nervous system or neuron, where it is present? See, it is present in the brain. Yeah, you know that brain is our supercomputer. So in brain we can see a number of these nervous tissues, or else neurons we can see. Upon that, it is present in the spinal cord. Spinal cord also very important thing for us, because for the responding for the stimuli it is very important. So that it is present in the entire spinal cord, and it is present in a nervous cells, or else nervous system. Entire nervous system is composed of neuron. Yes. Next we will see the structure, how it will be. It is very simple structure here. It is this. A nervous tissue is also called as neuron. See here, it is a structure of a neuron. Okay, very simple diagram I have drawn to you. See, student, see, it is very simple. See here, we can see a main part here. It is called as cell body. Come to know this part like a head. It is just you resemble these to a tree. How it will be tree? Tree has a root. Same as that, it is also having the root. But tree has main part, no, like a head portion. It is same as that. It is also having. But here, upon that, there will be a stem. Same as that, it is also a similar part. But the name is entirely different. See, student, here the cell body. Other all cells, we know that all has a cell organelle. Same as that, this is also having the cell organelle. Yeah, these neurons are the lengthiest, longest human or animal cell. For quiz, they will ask which is the longest cell in the human body. So you have to answer that. That is a neuron or nervous cell. See here, this is a cell body. It's composed of a cytoplasm in yellow color. I have drawn. No, see, I colored here yellow. That is a cytoplasm. Yeah, other all cell having same thing. It is also having. Next, it is, see, there will be at the center, there will be a nucleus like other cell. It is also having the controlling unit. That is a nucleus. Upon that, it is having the small hair like structure. Hair like structure in the cell body, that is nothing but a dendrite. Okay, dendrite. Next, there will be a elongated, see, elongated structure, that is called as axon. Axon. That axon are covered by a, see here, covered, that is called as myelin sheath. Actually, it is covered a sheath, it is called as a myelin sheath. Upon that, here we can see one more cell in dark. I have drawn, no? That is a, see here, Schwann cells. It is okay, Schwann cells. We can see at the end, we can see the nerve ending. Okay, while looking this, while observing this diagram, we come to know that this is a beginning part and this is a ending part, because nerve ending. So I will give you, student, how it is going to pass its impulses. So one cell it is. See, just imagine similar kind of cell is present over here. Okay, what happened? The nerve ending is going to give the impulses to the this cell. So these dendrites are going to receive that one, and it is passing through the axon, and once again it is giving back to the another cell, that is through the nerve ending. Come to know, nerve ending is at the end part. So two nerve cells are joining between, that place is called as a synapse. Come to know, synapse means nothing but that is a two neurons are joining one by one. See, like this, if it is one neuron here, it is going to join, right? This part is called as what? A synapse. Come to know? Yeah. Next, the neuron impulse allow us to move our muscle when we want to respond to a stimuli. So this is important question, student. In exam, they will ask you to draw the diagram of neuron. So you are able to draw. So I will draw you, student, how you have to draw these neurons. Very simple diagram I will, simple it is. So I will teach you how to draw. First, you have to draw a nucleus at the center, and you have to draw the cytoplasm like this. Come to know, cytoplasm like this, and this, after that you have to draw a small hair like structure like this in each and all end. You have to draw like this. Okay, one end you have to leave for the axon, just elongated that one, and draw here like this. That is the axon, and there will be a nerve ending. Come to know, next, after that, draw here a myelin sheath and here Schwann cells. Come to know? Yeah. This is a diagram how you have to draw. Come to know, student. After that, you are able to label the parts. Each part you have to label. Make it a center. Okay. Make it in a center nucleus. Okay. Yeah. This is all about the nervous tissue. So we come to know that what is the function of nervous tissue. Yes, nervous tissues are responsible for the stimuli. So that I have given two examples also. Okay, study by drawing, you have to study the diagram of nervous tissue. So we'll recall what we have studied in today's class. We have studied that similar to the plants, there is a tissues in the animals. That tissues are called as animal tissues. See, animal tissues are further classified into how many types? Four types. Muscular tissue, next, yeah, nervous tissue, epithelial tissue and connective tissue. In that, two tissues today we have studied, two more, rest epithelial and connective tissue we are going to study in the next class. After that, in muscle tissue we have studied that it has an elongated cell, is called as a muscle fibers, and they are responsible for the movement of the body, and they have a special kind of protein, is called as what? Contractile protein, that is responsible for the movement. Yeah, in that, three types are there once again in the muscular tissue. They are striated, unstriated and cardiac. What is striated? Yeah, we have studied the different characteristic also. Next, we have studied the unstriated, means what? Yeah, upon that we have studied the characteristic also and where it is found. Yeah, next we have studied the cardiac also. In that, cardiac tissues is also called as heart tissue, and we have studied the function and where it is found and characteristic. After that, next we studied about the nervous tissue, and we have structure, nice beautiful structure also we have learned. After that, what is the function of nervous tissue and where and all it is present, all those things we have discussed. Next, we will write down some questions, student. Take your book, write down some questions. Yeah. What are the difference between animal and plant tissues? Yes. Next, write down the four types of animal tissues. Third one, write down the characteristic of striated tissues. And one more question for the 5 marks they will ask usually. Along with the diagrams, you have to write the characteristic. Okay. Like this they will ask, differentiated, striated, unstriated and cardiac along with the diagram. So that you have to draw diagram, along with that you have to answer that one. Okay, you can draw three columns, and in that you can write it and draw the diagram separately. Okay, next, draw the neat label diagram of nervous tissue and functions of nervous tissues. Yes, thank you, students.